Okay, you're running business-critical workloads on top of CentOS Linux. But as of June 30th, 2024, CentOS Linux 7 will be going end of life. We understand you've got a lot of hard decisions to make and not a lot of time to make them. The CentOS Linux 7 end of life may seem daunting, but it's certainly not insurmountable. All you need to do is take a step back and consider, what workloads am I running today? Are you going to rip and replace, move to another community platform? Are you going to go to Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8 or RHEL 9? Containerization? Instead, you might consider using the Red Hat Enterprise Linux for third-party Linux migrations with extended lifecycle support, which, unlike the name, is going to introduce simplicity and decrease your downtime. Let's take a look at how easy it can be. What we're looking at here is a CentOS Linux 7 virtual machine. We're going to use this machine to do an in-place conversion from CentOS Linux 7 to Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7. Now, to do that, we obviously need the convert-to-RHEL utility. The thing to remember is that convert-to-RHEL is an officially supported process by Red Hat. So if you start this process and you run into any issues, you can immediately go and open a support ticket. So the first thing we need to do is enable and configure that repo. So we'll use the curl command to pull down the GPG key from Red Hat's website. The next thing we're going to pull down is we're going to set up the certificate directories and pull down the appropriate PEM file. Next, we're going to actually pull down the actual yum.repo.d convert-to-RHEL repository file. Now, with all those in place, let's go ahead and verify that our repo is configured. Sure enough, there it is, convert-to-RHEL for RHEL 7 RPMs. Now, let's install the convert-to-RHEL utility. I've gone ahead and done that. Next, we're going to run the convert-to-RHEL utility. So we're going to call the convert-to-RHEL utility, and then I'm going to use a combination of organization ID and activation key ID in order to authenticate our system to Red Hat. What that means is, instead of having to log in with our username and password on every single system we're converting, we can use an organization ID, which you can find at access.redhat.com in your customer portal, and an activation key that you'll create. I've also included the TACY, the hyphen Y at the end of the command, to go ahead and accept things like the end user license agreement, the EULA, and it'll ask me a couple of times if I'm actually sure I want to move on. So when I run my command, first thing I'll be presented with is the EULA, the end user license agreement. So the convert-to-RHEL utility went ahead and accepted that for me. Now it's pulling an inventory of all the packages, the BIOS configuration, any repositories that are enabled, and it's going to start pulling down some necessary packages, things like subscription manager. Next step is it's going to verify that all the RHEL 7 repositories that it's going to need are available. It's going to disable the CentOS Linux repositories. Now, so far, it hasn't made any changes that we can't reverse. It's backing up some of the configuration files and some of the packages, and now it's downloading all the packages it's going to need for the conversion process. So we've used a little bit of movie magic here to speed up this process. Usually it takes about an average of 15 to 20 minutes to run this. No one wants to sit here and watch packages download for 20 minutes. Now the system has brought up one of those checks. It says, so far, we haven't made any changes. It's made some backups, it's done some inventory, but once we pass that final warning, it's going to go ahead and start installing those packages. And what we'll see is it's going to install the kernel, OpenSSH, Network Manager, all the utilities that Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 is going to need. Once that process is done, it's actually going to build a second boot environment so that when we reboot our system, we'll be booting out of our CentOS Linux 7 environment and into a Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 environment. What that does is it allows you to make that easy switch. So right now we can see that it's doing that. The conversion was successful. So let's go ahead and reboot our CentOS Linux 7 system. This will take a minute or so because in the background, SE Linux is actually relabeling all your file system. But once that system has come back up, we can actually just SSH back into it and we'll put in our password. And now if I check the SE Red Hat release file, you'll see that we are, in fact, running Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7.9. And from here, you can do an in-place upgrade to Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8 or RHEL 9. But if you're not ready to go all in on that just yet, you have the option for additional time. In fact, with our third-party Linux migration offering, you have the ability to receive software updates for RHEL 7 for up to 4 years beyond the end of life of CentOS Linux 7. This allows you to run the same workloads on the same servers while you plan your next move. And of course, Red Hat's offerings are available for purchase on-premise or through cloud marketplaces. Plus, a Red Hat Enterprise Linux subscription provides you with a predictable lifecycle, published release cadence, access to Red Hat Insights, security certifications, software updates, and of course, our amazing support teams. So don't get caught behind. Start planning your migration today.